So far we've looked at addition and multiplication. Now we'll focus on subtraction of counting number and whole numbers, and then see how it works for subtracting other objects as well. So let's start with something simple. We have 7 apples and we want to take away 4 apples. So in kindergarten or first grade or second grade, wherever you learned it, you're probably going to ask to be counting down 4 from 7. So take away 4 apples. So here's first apple gone, second apple gone, third apple gone, fourth apple gone. We're left with 3 apples. Another way sometimes people ask you to subtract is to count down from 7. So it would be 6, 5, 4, 3. And that's how you count down 4 from 7. All right, so 7 minus 4 apples equals 3 apples. Before we can do more subtraction, let's just talk about some additional concepts that will aid us in the subtraction process. Two objects, A and B, are called additive inverses of each other if and only if their sum is the additive identity. In this particular case, where we're working with mathematical objects where 0 is our additive identity, then if the addition of the two objects give us additive identity of 0, then A and B are going to be additive inverses. A is additive inverse of negative A, and negative A is additive inverse of A, okay? Because they added together give you 0. So 2 is additive inverse of negative 2, because 2 plus negative 2 is 0. Similarly, square root x plus 1 and negative square root x plus 1 will give you 0. X squared, negative x squared are additive inverses of each other. Negative f of x and f of x are additive inverses of each other. So here are a few examples of what additive inverse is. All right, take a look at 2 times negative 1. We're going to say 2 times negative 1, 2 copies of negative 1. So it's negative 1 plus negative 1, giving you a negative 2. Okay? So let's take a look. Another way you can visualize negative numbers is on the number line. So we have 2 copies of negative 1. So negative 1 distance once and negative 1 distance twice. So when you're going negative 1, you're going to the left. So in general then, look, 1 plus negative 1 times 2 is the same as 0 times 2, because 1 and negative 1 are additive inverses of each other. So we have 0 times 2 is 0. So distributive property of multiplication over addition, we have 1 times 2 plus negative 1 times 2, which gives us 2 plus negative 1 times 2 equaling 0. What does that mean to you? Whatever the value of negative 1 times 2 is, that is going to be an additive inverse of 2, because they're adding up to 0. That was our definition of additive inverse. So what does that mean? We already know what's additive inverse of 2. Do you remember? Oh, come on. What's additive inverse of 2? We just did it right before. If not, rewind the video and go find what additive inverse of 2 is if you can't find the answer on your own. Yes, good, good, good. Yes, negative 2 is the additive inverse of 2. So negative 1 times 2 is how much then? Negative 2, very good. So negative 1 times 2 has to be negative 2, because that's additive inverse of 2. So negative 1 times 2 is negative 2. Keep that in mind. All right, in general then, negative 1 times A is the additive inverse of A, which is negative A. Similarly, A times negative 1 is also additive inverse of A, or negative A. So we're observing that multiplying by a negative 1 always gives us the additive inverse. All right, let's take a look at multiplicative inverse. So just like we had two numbers adding together giving you additive identity, we have additive inverses. So two numbers or objects multiplying together giving you multiplicative identity will be a multiplicative inverses. So let's do 4 times a quarter, see how we can interpret that. We want 4 copies or 4 groups of 1/4. So take a look. So we have 1/4 and we have 4 of those. So 1, 2, 3, and 4. If you have four copies of a quarter added together, remember, repeated addition, then what are you going to get? You're going to get a whole, because that's my whole. A quarter makes, four quarters make a whole. Now let's look at interpretation of 1/4 times 4. So we have 4 apples here, and I want to take a quarter of that. So if I take a quarter of that, that will give me 1 apple, because I have 4 equal pieces, and I want a quarter of that. So that will be 1 apple. So 1/4 times 4 is 1. Let's take a look at formal definition then. If A is a non-zero mathematical object, then we're going to say B is multiplicative inverse of A if and only if their product, product means multiplying them together, is the multiplicative identity, which means that for our case, since 1 is our multiplicative identity, we want two things multiplying together, giving us 1. If that happens, then A and B are multiplicative inverses of each other. So for example, 1/5 times 5 is 1. So 1/5 is multiplicative inverse of 5. Similarly, 5 is multiplicative inverse of 1/5. 8 is multiplicative inverse of 1/8, since 8 times 1/8 equals 1. See if you can verify why 8 times 1/8 should equal 1, or why 1/5 times 5 should equal 1. So in summary then, multiplying a non-zero mathematical object by its multiplicative inverse gives us what? 1, good. Now recall, what was a to the negative 1? Do you remember? That was the same as writing 1 over a. That was the definition of negative exponents that we had in the first module. If you are unfamiliar with that, you might want to go back and review that. This is an important distinction we're going to make. Look, a to the negative 1, as you've seen before, is 1 over a. And we know 1 over a times a is 1. So a to the negative 1 is multiplicative inverse of a. Whereas negative a, which is negative 1 times a, is the additive inverse of a. Look at the difference. When the negative 1 is in the exponent, you get multiplicative inverse. But if you are multiplying the object by negative 1, you end up with additive inverse. Okay, that's very, very important. To the power of negative 1 means, think of multiplicative inverse. Multiplying by negative 1 means additive inverse. Additive inverses have opposite signs, like 2 and negative 2. You can see how 2 is to the right of 0, negative 2 is to the left of 0. They are symmetrically positioned around 0. However, multiplicative inverses have the same sign. They are on the same side of 0, not on the opposite sides of 0. Let's talk about distributive property of multiplication over subtraction. See if you can pause the video here and draw a picture for what 3 times 6 minus 2 represents. Go ahead. Well, we know that 3 times 6 is going to be 3 rows of 6. But we're saying 3 rows of 6 minus the 2. 6 minus the 2. 6 minus the 2, 3 times. So 3 times 6 minus 2 will look like this. How many is that? That's 12, right? Okay, so 3 times 6, which is 3 rows of 6. Do you see that? Okay, and then what? We want to take away these 2, right? So that means what? Take away 3 times 2. So that's 1, 2, 3. 3 rows of 2 were taken out. So either way, you end up with 12. So 3 times 6 minus 2, that was, you lay down a row of 6, take away 2. Lay down a row of 6, take away 2, and so on 3 times. Whereas here, you lay down 3 rows of 6 first, and then took away 3 rows of 2. Either way, you ended up with 12. So distribution of multiplication over subtraction does work. Multiplication distributes over subtraction and also addition. All right, let's take a look at 6 minus 2 times 3. So that's 4 rows of 3, basically. But if you do it the other way, you can also do 6 times 3, which is 6 rows of 3, and then take away 2 rows of 3. And same thing then. So you can see how answer will be 18 minus 6, or 12 again. And so distributive property of multiplication would be A times B minus C is AB minus AC. And you can do the same in the other direction because of commutative property of multiplication. So multiplication distributes over subtraction. Whether you have two terms, three terms, four terms, does not matter. You just multiply each term, term by term. All right? All right, let's start with examples. Perform the operation, simplify this first one. 2 times negative 4x, how do you think we should do that? 2 copies of negative 4 added together, giving you negative 8x. All right, think of this next problem in terms of true or false. If I have negative 2 times negative 4x, can I do this? Negative 2 times negative 4 and negative 2 times x. Is this a true statement or a false statement? Think about it. Pause the video, please. Okay, you know, if you said true, that is not correct. This is a false statement. Why is that? Because think about negative 2 times negative 4x as additive inverse of 2 times negative 4x, which we just did right there. What's additive inverse of negative 8x? Is 8x. So negative 2 times negative 4x is 8x. Whereas what happens here? Negative 2 times negative 4 is 8. 8 times negative 2 is negative 16. Times x, negative 16x. So multiplication does not distribute over multiplication. This is why we're making such a big deal about you remembering the whole words, not just distributive property, but distributive property of multiplication over addition, or distributive property of multiplication over subtraction. Just remember all of the words so that you do not have a chance to misuse the distributive property of multiplication over addition or subtraction. All right, simplify this and explain what properties you used. Go ahead. We'll discuss the answer in just a few seconds. All right, so we have negative 15x squared. Why? Because x times x is x squared. I can multiply the x's first using associative and commutative property of multiplications. And then 3 times negative 5, which is negative 5 plus negative 5 plus negative 5, 3 times, which will give me negative 15. So using commutative and associative property of multiplication, I can multiply these together. All right, so identify the property of real numbers that justify each equation. So here are all the properties that we've studied so far: commutative property of addition, multiplication, and so on. Okay, zero product property means if I multiply by zero, zero times a quantity is going to give me zero. We didn't explicitly discuss this, but that's what it means. So zero times a number is zero. Okay, let's see. We'll put an equation here, and then you check the box of which property is being used. So I'll put the equation here, pause the video, and you find the check. You're multiplying by zero, so something times zero is zero. What property is that? Well, that's the zero property. All right, here's the next equation. Do it on your own. Half times 2 is 1. What property is that? 1/2 times 2 is 1. 2 and 1/2 are multiplicative inverses of each other. That's why you end up with 1. All right, do the next one on your own. Because when you add these two together, you end up with 0 because those two are additive inverses of each other. All right, try this one. 5 minus 0 is 5 because why? Because additive identity. Good. 0 is additive identity. 5 times x plus y times x. What have we done? We've distributed multiplication over addition. Good.